the road between Tanga and Pangani.
Breakfast here this morning on D-Day. Thank Gervin in the corner.
I want to ride my bicycle.
Travels begin.
I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride my bike. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride it where I like.
You say black,
I say white.
You say bar,
I say bite.
You say shark,
I say him. And yours was never my scene, and I don't like Star Wars.
You say Rose,
I say Royce.
Cycling into the sunset. Day what?
Day four.
On the Phoenix.
We're on a mission from Makuniki to, where are we going? Mamba.
Mamba.
Mamba at the bottom of the.
Mambo.
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 And we got one flat tire out there. Water strapped all over the show. Bit surfing off bikes. Punctures. Pumps falling apart. Wicked sunset. Stunning. Big up in African plane. And couldn't be better. That's what the blue horn has to say about that.
How are you doing, Angus?
Spiffy. Really spiffy.
What about Selkie?
And Miss Selkie? With a flat tire?
With a flat tire, but A, shower, plus B, not willing to ride the dark, equals C, speed.
It's majestic, dreary, hairy mountains. Just awesome.
You say Coke,
I say Kane,
you say John,
I say Wayne,
hot dog,
I say cooler man, I don't want to be the president of America.
Kilimanjaro should be right there. And we cannot see it. What is wrong? Where is Kilimanjaro? We're gonna look for it right now.
All right, 10 kilometers outside Moshi. Pull them into Moshi.
How's the tires? No, no punctures.
And looking back at magnificent Mount Kilimanjaro.
It's coming into Arusha and it is noisy and smelly and sweaty and beautiful all at the same time. Got diesel everywhere. And up behind you might be able to see awesome view of Mount Meru. But man, there is just traffic everywhere. It's what is commonly known as the pumping operation. See, great technique here from John. What are the keys to technique, John?
Straight arms.
Yes.
Bends the knees. Bends the knees like I told you.
Oh, very good. Also, it's important to have as many hands as possible in and around repairs.
Live action here in the plains of Africa. We have a grid bag in the hand of Aukje. Be serious.
Distribute it door to door. Just me and my bike.
Just me and my bike. night, or just me and my red shiny hand-me-down bike, pedaling into the next life, leaving my sorrows behind.
Halfway across the Rift Valley, Lake Manyara's over there. This is a road gifted by the Japanese government without any holes. It's really flat for a change. And that's the way to the Serengeti and Ngorongoro Crater. So we're on our way. Woohoo! Forgot the bike.
Do they stop and wonder why just me and my bike?
Just me and my bike.
Just me and my red shiny hand me down. Just me and my red shiny hand me down bike.
Here we are on the escarpment of the Rift Valley, looking across to the valley itself. In the distance, just the thin blue wedge before the horizon, is Lake Manyara.
This is the final leg of a Baskeli journey. Up in the highlands now, heading towards Karatu, which is about 3 or 4 kilometers away. After this magnificent bicycle ride from the coast. Oh my goodness! We've got speed wobbles. Formation running here, requiring a lot of technical skill. These riders are now expert, so-called, in the art of Baskeli riding. Formation leader Angus Argyle here, leading the routine, followed by Aukje van Gerven and John Earl. Stunning stuff. Not only do they need maneuvers here, but oh, look at that. Oh, that is just champagne.
Sunset at Lake Iasi. All right, so here we are at the entrance to the Serengeti National Park.
And we're looking at some cubs, and it's absolutely quiet. We're the only people here. Oh no, wait, we're not.
Alright, we're in the Ngorongoro Conservation Area. Marshy pond. So this is the gorge where the earliest evidence of humans' ancestors have been found in the world.
Journey to the source, 2008.